They claim the soul Bible has outlived its day, that there are some changes that need to be made. Let no man deceive.
Take your Bibles or turn with me to Matthew 24.
Truth is determined by the test of time. Trust the old Bible with its these and that's. Never mind those people who won't throw it out. Churches are drifting. Sacred, oh, what do children do? Our way of life is changing, and people don't care. The signs of the end, they're seen everywhere. Trust the old Bible with its these and that's. Never mind those people who want to throw it out. Church are drifting and falling away. We need the soul book more than ever today. They've criticized, maligned it, and slandered it too. Some say it's inferior and simply will not do. They've tried to replace it and shove it aside. Said it will abide. Trust the old Bible with its these and thous. Never mind those people who won't throw it out. Churches are drifting and falling away. We need this soul book more than ever today. Jesus is coming.
Welcome to Empty Cross Ministries Daily Devotional Time. I'm Brother David, and the name of the program is King James Version Exposed. Because we use the King James Version, we look at the verses, bring them to life, and expose the meaning. I would encourage you to read along with and follow along with Empty Cross Ministries Daily Bible Reading Plan, which can be found on Empty Cross Ministries Facebook page, Empty Cross Ministries Group Facebook page, my own personal Facebook page, as well as on our website, www.emptycrossministries.com. If you go to the website, there's a little square at the right-hand corner of the screen. You need to click on that to get to the Daily Bible Reading Plan and the Daily Devotionals and our Wednesday Bible Study. I would also encourage you to listen in on Wednesday evenings for our Wednesday Bible study. You will be greatly encouraged and blessed by that. Today we're going to be looking at Roamns chapter 16. This is the last chapter in the book of Roamns. And I've entitled today's episode, What is Church Supposed to Be? Okay. As Paul concludes his letter to the Roman church, he spent the whole chapter remembering Christians he knew in the ministry. He named 28 individuals and remarked what they had meant to him or how they had been useful in the ministry. They were more than acquaintances to him. The people in a church were close to his heart. Going to church for us should also be more than just nodding at people as they pass us in the aisle or shaking their hands as we see them in Sunday school. Church is where those of like faith and beliefs gather. It should be a place removed from the world, where we can be with our own kind, Christians. In that place, we are no longer a peculiar people as the unsaved sees us. In that fellowship, we are with others of similar beliefs. We are with members of the family of God. Church is a place where some hear the gospel for the first time and get saved. It should be a place where the Bible is taught and people learn more about God's Word. In church, Christians can hear what the Lord has laid on the under-shepherd's heart and learn how they can be better Christians. It is a place where people can be burdened for needs they see or hear about and can get involved in a ministry themselves. Also, importantly, church is a place where we are among those of like faith. I know I can't speak for all churches, as too many have too much of the world in them, but church should be a place where we can be far from godless living and be closer to God. In church, we can be encouraged by other Christians. All week, we are swimming against the current of the world. It can spiritually tire us out. Being around our own kind can reward us with advice, encouragement, or even seeing how other Christians handle their problems, so we can successfully run our own spiritual race. Those Christians that are not faithful in church attendance miss the help and encouragement of being around their own kind. It's not just the preaching, teaching, church dinners, and special events that we need. We need to feel for the time we are with others of like faith that we are not alone in this world. We need to know that there are others like us. No wonder Paul addressed many individually. They were important to him because they were part of his spiritual family, the family of God. Our thought for today is this. Going to church is family time. And what's missing from church? Think of the word church in your mind. C-H blank blank church. You are. That brings us up to our scripture of Roamns chapter 16. And after I get a drink here, I'm going to read the entire chapter. Excuse me. Roamns chapter 16, beginning of verse 1. Once again, I am reading from the King James Version. I commend unto you Phoebe, our sister, which is a servant of the church, which is at Cenchreae, that you receive her in the Lord as becometh saints, and that ye assist her in whatsoever business she hath need of, for she hath been a succor of many, and of myself also. Greet Priscilla and Aquila, my helpers in Christ Jesus, who have for my life laid down their own necks, unto whom not only I give thanks, but also all the churches of the Gentiles. Likewise, greet the church that is in their house. Salute my well-beloved Epaphras, who is the firstfruits of Achaia unto Christ. Greet Mary, who bestowed much labor on us. Salute Andronicus and Junia, my kinsmen and my fellow prisoners, who are of note among the apostles, who also were in Christ before me. Greet Amplius, my beloved in the Lord. Salute Urbane, our helper in Christ, and Stachius, my beloved. Salute Apelles, approved in Christ. Salute them which are of Aristobulus' household. Salute Herodian, my kinsman. Greet them that be of the household of Narcissus, which are in the Lord. Salute Typhrenia and Tryphosa, who labor in the Lord. Salute the beloved Persis, which labored much in the Lord. Salute Rufus, chosen in the Lord, and his mother and mine. Salute Asinicritus, Philegon, Hermas, Patrobas, Hermes, and the brethren which are with them. Salute Philogos, and Julia, Nereus, and his sister, and Olympas, and all the saints which are with them. Salute one another with an holy kiss. The churches of Christ salute you. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which you have learned, and avoid them. For they that are such serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly, and by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple. For your obedience is come abroad unto all men. I am glad, therefore, on your behalf, but yet I would have you wise unto that which is good and simple concerning evil. And the God of peace shall bruise Satan under your feet shortly. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen. Timotheus, my workfellow, and Lucius, and Jason, and Sosipater, my kinsmen, salute you. I, Tertius, who wrote this epistle, salute you in the Lord. Gaius, mine host, and of the whole church, saluteth you. Erastus, the chamberlain of the city, saluteth you. And Quartus, a brother, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Now to him that is of power to establish you according to my gospel and the preaching of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery, which was kept secret since the world began, but now is made manifest, and by the scriptures of the prophets, according to the commandment of the everlasting God, made known to all nations for the obedience of faith. To God only wise be glory through Jesus Christ forever. Amen. This has been Empty Cross Ministries Daily Devotional Time. I'm Brother David. The name of the program is King James Version Exposed. Once again, I would encourage you to read along with and follow along with Empty Cross Ministries Daily Bible Reading Plan. Each day there's a passage from the Old Testament and one from the New Testament, and it only takes 10-15 minutes of reading time to complete reading those passages. I would also encourage you to listen in Wednesday evenings for our Wednesday Bible study. You'll be greatly blessed and encouraged by that. We're going to close out here with a prayer and a song. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, open our eyes, open our hearts, open our minds to those fellowships that we call churches that teach and preach your word and expound your word and follow your doctrines that are contained in your preserved word, the Holy Bible. Father, we know you are all-knowing, all-powerful, and ever-present. We thank you that you walk with us no matter where we go or what we do. You are there right beside us. Father, be with those who are suffering from any kind of illness, whether it be physical, mental, emotional, or spiritual. Just put your healing touch upon them. Be with those who are facing the loss of a loved one. Just grant them your peace that passes understanding. Father, we thank you for all that you do, the beauty of your creation, the beauty of the sunset, the beauty of the sunrise, the beauty of the night sky, the majesty of the mountains, the peacefulness of the rivers, the strength that the oceans show us. It is these things that speak of your honor, of your power, and of your glory. Father, we ask that you forgive us when we fall short of your glory. We thank you for sending your son Jesus to shed his blood and die on the cross, that those things might be hid from your face. It's in his name we pray these things. Amen. Folks, stay safe, be blessed, stay in the word, and write the word upon your heart. Until next time.
Until we fall, when God dips his hand of love in my heart. Oh. Yeah.